Hey everyone, welcome to another edition of Rap by Rap. This is Scott from Country Roads Fly Company coming at you from wild, wonderful West Virginia, USA. And in this edition, we're going to talk about a collar style hackle. So let's dive right into it. So I've got a traditional Adams dry fly started here and I'm ready to dress it with a hackle. Now, normally this fly recipe calls for two hackles, a grizzly and a brown. We happen to have some nice Cree rooster capes here at the shop, so I'm going to tie this with just one Cree hackle feather. But before I get into the hackle itself, just a word about the base on which the hackle is going to be wrapped. This area here, from where the dubbing starts all the way forward to where the final hackle tie-off will be. So if you watched our video on thread management, I talked a little bit about this. This area, it's really important to keep it tidy and neat. And you want to make sure you use a flattened thread. So I'm going to spin my bobbin and flatten this thread and just make sure that thread base is nice and tidy and as smooth as possible. Moving the thread up to about where I want to initially tie in my hackle. Now, I'm going to take this hackle feather with the dull side up, I'm going to tie it in on the near side of the shank. Making thread wraps towards the wings. And then I'm going to stop just shy of the wings. Now you'll note that I left enough of the bare hackle stem such that it reaches the start of the dubbing, the start of the body of the fly. So there's quite a bit of bare hackle stem extending all the way to where the hackle feather meets the body. So I'm going to further secure this hackle stem in front of the wings, and then I'm going to clip off the feather butt. Okay. And then I'm going to attach my hackle pliers. Now, I'm still in front of the wings. My first wrap, I'm going to go underneath the wings. You'll see the feather twist at this point. I'm going to make my first wrap behind the wings. I'm going to work back, take another wrap behind the wings. And then I'm going to come forward between those two previous wraps. I'm going to take one more wrap right up against the wings. At this point, we've got all the wraps that we're going to do behind the wings. And you notice some of the hackle fibers start to splay rearward, which is what we want. Now, my next wrap, I'm going to pass underneath the wings and come out just in front of the wings, holding my wings back. Make sure I get nice and tight against the wings. And I'm just going to make subsequent wraps forward. A few wraps forward. I'm going to do one more. I'm not to cinch down any of the hackle fibers at this point, or cinch down as few as you can. There's going to be some stragglers more than likely that you in a void. I'm going to take a couple wraps using my left hand. Take a couple wraps of thread while maintaining tension on the hackle feather with my right. I take my scissors. Trim the hackle feather as close to the hook shank as I can. And snip. Then I'm going to hold back the feathers and the hackles in front. Make sure the trimmed hackle feather is tied off completely before I start to form my head. And more than likely, there's going to be some straggler hackles that you can clip off. So at this point, I'm just going to whip finish here. That'll complete this Adams. So like I mentioned, this approach that I just demonstrated is more of a modern approach to hackling a fly. There's a lot of different ways you can do this. The more classic approach is to start with the hackle feather behind the wings, whereas I started in the front with my first wrap going under the wings, coming out behind. That forced some of these feathers to angle rearward. And then when I came from the back to the front, that forced some hackle feathers to angle forward. If you take a more classic approach and start the hackle feather behind the wings and just take forward wraps the whole way, the hackle tends to be straighter. It looks very nice. But this method provides a wider footprint with the hackles, some hackles facing rearward, some facing forward. It gives your fly a little more support on the water as it floats on the surface of the water. And it helps prevent your fly from tipping forward and falling on its nose, so to speak, as is the case with some classically hackled flies. So that's about it for this edition of Wrap by Wrap. I hope you found this video on hackling a dry fly helpful. Thanks for watching.